Everybody, I'm back, and I want you to see I have all the orange dots done, the patterns done. We have the white, the light orange, and a little bit darker orange, and then I went ahead and put the yellow dots in, and I made them on a little bit larger size, and then I took and I washed off all of the chalk marks that I had on the bowl, and I put new ones on, a new pattern. So what I did was, hi everybody. So you saw the real quick photo of the bowl with the new design on it. Now I'm going to show you how to create it on this piece of paper or our little square practice sheet. So the first thing I've done is I've made the yellow dots. Next, I want to measure, which I've done. I measured 1/2 inch. From right this line right here, because it's about halfway between the yellow. So there's 1/2 inch and 1/4 inch. And I am going to make the circle so we can get it dark enough for you. There we go. And then I'm going to go up 1/4 inch. And I'm going to make another half circle. And I'm only making a half circle because that's as far as it'll go on here. On your bowl, you're going to make a full circle all the way around your bowl. Okay, now next, I'm going to make lines. I get my pencil. And I'm going to make lines that are going to go from the center dot on the bowl, the white center dot on the bowl, and it goes all the way up through the center of the yellow. And you'll make a line up. Now this won't be perfect because this is my practice one. And I'll go up the center all the way to the end of the bowl. Just like that. And then I take and I will go from the center between the two yellows. And I'll make another line. These may not be perfect because this is my practice sheet. But it's, and of course I'm not using my measuring tape. But on the bowl, you're going to want to use your measuring tape and go from the center line, which is on here, it's right there. That's like the white dot on your bowl. Go from your center line through the center of the yellow dot. And you can see that line's kind of off. But if it weren't, it would go like so. Okay, so I have that done. Next, I'm going to want to start the pattern, and the pattern is different. So I'm going to take my smallest, smallest crochet hook, and I'm going to do white dots. And what I'm going to do, I'll dip it in my white, and I'm going to go above the yellow dot, right up to the 1/4 inch one up there. So we've gone past the 1/2 inch to the 1/4 inch line. And I'll go above each yellow mark. And I would go all the way around the bowl making those dots. Okay. Then I'm going to take the line between the yellow dots and go up to the 1/2 inch mark and make a dot. Okay, we're doing pretty good here. I'm going to go over that one a little bit. And that one. There. So, and you'll do that all the way around the bowl. Then, to take the medium stylus tool. Okay, remember we have three that we use for patterns. We have smaller one, the medium one, and the large one. So this is the medium one. All right, so I'm going to dip it in the white because this pattern, part of this pattern, is all white, and I'm going to go from the top. Right here at the side, hit the line, and I'm going to V bounce from there straight across to there. Then I'm going to go down to the yellow to its line between the two yellows, and I'm going to bounce all the way up to there. And that's how the pattern starts to work. It's looking really good. So over on this side, I'm going to go to the line, and I'm going to bounce. Let me get one more in there. Okay, to there. And then I'm going to go down to the yellow line, the yellow dot, and I'm going to bounce it up to there. And that's our design. Being that they're not perfectly coordinated, some of them won't look quite right, but on your bowl it'll look awesome. You'll see. So again, go to the line, bounce down. Okay, go to the yellow, bounce up. Go to the little one. Go down to the yellow. Go down to the yellow. I want to see how my V looks there. Oh, much better. Okay. Go down here. And that's our, here we go. That's sort of what the pattern is going to look like. It'll be much nicer on the bowl because it's cleaner. Now I'm going to show you it on the bowl. Okay. So then I'm going to... Okay, now we're back. The next step is to make the teardrops. And let's see if I can show you a teardrop. There's a teardrop I made at one point, just to kind of give you an idea. And they're really quite easy to make. I'm going to use the larger of my stylus tool to make the teardrops. And it's just putting a dot and then dragging the dot. That's all it is. And you can practice over here. These will be dragged further, so you can drag it further. Looks pretty good. Okay, so first thing I'm going to do is do the darker of my pinks. And I'm going to go down. I have the line here, so I'm going to go onto the line and make my dot and then pull it down. Dot and pull it down. More stuff on it here. Okay, make my dot and then pull it down. There we go. Okay, and then we're going to make the dot on the line here. And then we're going to probably off my line because my line's not very good. I want a little more on there. I want a nice full dot. And then I'm going to pull it down and pull it down. Goes down to the yellow. And it's looking pretty nice. Okay, then we're going to go to this one. Same thing. It's good practice. Just put your dot in there and pull it down. Okay, so now I have those three. Now you're going to do that all the way around the whole gourd in your design. Then we're going to go to a lighter color of the pink. We're going to go to the sides of these, and we're going to put a dot here and pull it down. There. Okay. Lighter color. Put the dot here and pull it down. Now, on your bowl, you won't be over lopsided like this is. You won't have a bunch of room here and a bunch of room here. It should be pretty close to the same on either side. So that's just showing that it's practice, and it's not perfect. Okay, so we're going to go into this side, this one, pull it down. Pull it down. There we go. And we're going to go to this side. go. And that's, you're going to do that all the way around. It looks really cool. Now, like some of the teardrops may not be perfect enough for you. And what I do is I take my DiniPen, which I don't have with me right this minute, but I take the DiniPen and go over the edges of this and clean it up. And then they look more perfect. Depends on the feel you want or how much you like your teardrops. Okay, so I'm going to show you what it looks like with the teardrops on the bowl. Oh, what do we got? And the next part is going to be going up, and I'm going to use this same small crochet hook, the smallest one, and we're going to start our regular pattern because we're going to go in between each of these and put the yellow dot. I won't go through all of those because I'm just showing you now what we're going to do next. Okay, then I'm going to take a light green. And I'm going to put that in here. Let's see. Okay. I'm going to take a size, I believe I want to take the size blue. Okay, so the blue large crochet hook, or the second largest crochet hook. And I'm going to dip it in the green. And I'm going to put it right here. And we're going to put the next one right here. You can kind of get a gist of your pattern because we're back to what our pattern is. Then we're okay. Here we are. We've got the yellow dots done. We have the little fan type thing. Now, as you noticed, I've taken and put in between the dots here. Okay, on the yellow dots, I put a gold dot instead of a yellow dot on them because, of course, you don't put a yellow dot on a yellow dot. So I put gold, and then what I did was I took the gold. Let's see if I can show you here. There we go. The gold that I put here, I went ahead and did with dots in between the teardrops. So I have three gold dots between each of the teardrops, and then in between the teardrops, the V that's right here, I took the gold on the small stylus, and I put the dot first dot here, and then I went down and bumped down to being smaller and smaller. If I lift this up, you can see the yellow dot and the green dot, and inside the green dot is the yellow dot. We're starting our pattern. Okay, so then the next step would be to go back to our old pattern, which I started here, and I put the white first from our pattern, and then the next, and I will go all the way around, and then the next one will be this will be a lighter green next, and then a darker green, and then we'll see where our pattern's at that time and see where it's up on the bowl, because we want the bowl. I'm not sure exactly how I'm going to show you that. Yeah, we're only going to go so high up the bowl, and then we're going to stop, and then we'll go from there on what we decide to do at that point. Okay, so I'm going to take that spin break. You'll see it in a hot second here. And these will be done. Okay, I've got those done. And I'm going to try the green row now. I put the light on because I wanted you to see the bright colors and how good it looks, but it might be a little blurry. So I'm going to turn the light off because the light makes it kind of not really clear, but it's kind of dark there. So I hope you can see it okay. Okay, I'm going to take my middle one and I'm going to do the green. As you can see, I've already done one green. Now I'm going to do another one just for you guys, and then we'll stop. Just hop around. Just hop those around. Looking big enough so that they last all the way around. There we go. To the other side, go over the first one, then hop around. If it's not enough, put a little more on your, a little more paint on there. And there we go. So we have two of them. Okay? Okay, I'll be back in a minute. Okay, so we have our three rows of patterns. We have the white, the lighter green, and the darker green. It's looking good. Now you can see how far it is from here to the end of the bowl. And I think that I'm going to do an ending on the bowl right now for this part. And so I'm going to take white and I'm going to try to get them all dots close to the same size. Just outline each of these with white for the pattern. Now we're going to take, and I'm just going to try to find a way to do this so you can see what I'm doing. Okay, so I'm going to just keep dipping and going. And going down. And I'm going to try to keep them pretty much the same size. I don't want a bump. And then when I get to there, I really can't go down. Well, maybe I can go one more. Let's see. Okay, so I want one more. Now I'm going to take that and go up the next one. Okay, but instead of going up this way, I start at the top of the next one. At the top. Let's see if I can get this to where you can see what I'm doing. Okay. And then I'm going to just go down to keep them close to the same size. It's a little smaller, so I'm going to make it bigger. There we go. Yep. And then put one more right in there. Okay. So that's going to end this round. Okay? So I'm going to keep going. I'm going to just keep right on going. Ensure they're all close to the same size. And if they look a little smaller, I'll just go over them again. Not a problem. Stop there with that one, because I want them approximately the same going around where I start and finish. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and complete this, and I'll be back. Okay, we are here. I have finished the dots around all the green pattern. Beautiful. This part of the bowl is done. I'm not going to paint any more dots above onto the pattern. Okay, this pattern is complete. Now you can if you want to, or you can say, that's it, I'm not going to do any more, the outside of my bowl is done. Or you can do what I'm going to do, and I'm going to take, and I put a white dot over here, you can see the white dot, okay, I put a dot there and I put three of them. I put one where I could find my butterfly. Because my butterfly comes out. Let's see, I'm kind of getting, there we go. A little lost, there we go. Okay, so my butterfly, it gets kind of lost, all right? And I found the three parts that are still showing in the black. And I kind of want the pattern going over it. So I put a dot there, and I put a dot where each of my three butterflies are. There's one. You can do that part or not. It's up to you. If you do it, take your, start your white dot. It's going to be this one. And just go out just the same colors. Unless you want to do different, you can do whatever you like. But I start here, and I go out, and I keep going until I decide to stop. And I like it to go into the white dots along the outside, so it kind of gives it I'm going underneath and this part's coming over the top of them. Okay, I'll show you when I'm done, but I'm not going to show you how I do it because you've already learned how to do this. There's no reason to be repetitious. You've learned this. Now, for the inside of the bowl. If you're going to do the inside of the bowl, you're going to start the same as this one. Center, white dot in the center. Take and go out. Just go to your part three, painting one. Follow it all the way out until you get to the teardrops. When you get to the teardrops and you finish those, that's the end. That's all you put in the center. Don't put the green last pattern. Don't put this one. Let's see. You don't want to put this one here. You want to stop there at this pattern. That's the inside. And then the inside is done. So I'm going to go and take the afternoon and finish off the bowl on the inside and the outside. And then I will come back and show you how to create your butterflies. All right, see you then.